Rain. I doubt even you would be able to read the stars in this weather, Ramada.
Stars are neither for reading nor seeing, Your Majesty. Those who rely solely on their eyes will overlook what is of true import.
Then how is it done? By clicking?
If it serves, yes. But if you listen closely, you can hear it. The whispering song of the star.
And what do the stars sing of?
Blood and ruin. A song that will illuminate the world in radiant light at the end of...
Blood and ruin? Must be the ever-growing menace the monsters damn us with. And a radiant light at the end of it all, you say? Oh, interesting. Could mean wealth, or maybe glory.
Monsters are not the only beings capable of bringing about blood and ruin.
Could it be that a great war is on the horizon?
It may be just so, Your Majesty.
A war with Fenris.
Fenris is not alone in targeting our homeland. The great houses of Horn and Wazette also share.
That may be so, but we harbor no ill will toward Horn.
For the time being, should that balance be destroyed, what
havoc would run through our humble nation?
More monsters!
Cut them down, Mont.
Yes, Father!
We'll be right back.
that carriage.
Opportune timing.
Your Majesty, they wear the armor of Horn.
What is a carriage from Horn doing in Leona's territory?
They must have crossed our border while being pursued by bandits.
That is not out of the realm of possibility.
It matters not. Let us seize this opportunity to win Horn's favor.
So, the King of Leonis graces us with his...
You fail to distinguish between friend and foe?
Silence! I'll cut you all down at once. And who is this wretch?
Lilith, commander of Leonis's infantry.
Chutzalt, first sword of Solidus, Horn's royal guard.
Oh, I've heard a thing or two about you. The reckless first sword, am I?
As have I about you, Blaze of the Battlefield. You certainly look the part.
And if you don't watch your tongue when addressing His Majesty, I'll be sure to burn you to nothing but ashes.
Amusing, aren't we? Shall I befoul the fallen rain with your blood?
Enough.
But, Lady Marcherie...
Did he say Marcherie? Well, if it isn't the Princess of Horn herself...
She's the beautiful Steel Maiden?
It seems this is Leona's territory. We apologize for the trouble caused.
Pay it no mind. It is fortunate that Leonis and Horn are not on hostile terms. It would be our pleasure to have you as honored guests.
You have my deepest gratitude.
Mont, take care not to embarrass yourself in front of us.
I won't!
Mont, where have I heard that name before?
Now, to make these bandits regret setting foot in my kingdom.
Thank you.
Enemy reinforcements!
They don't seem like just any old...
It could be that a foreign power is pulling their strings.
You might be right.
Do you truly believe such a thing?
What reason would we have to lie?
If not Leonis, then... Could they be in the service of Wizette?
It's possible. Horn and Wizette are at odds with one another after all.
Choose your words, Watless, you have forgotten. Wizette and Leonis are on friendly terms.
Right now, it doesn't matter from whence these thugs hail. The problem is their numbers. Any thoughts, King Elda?
Meeting force with force.
I take it you have a plan.
Abandon the carriage. Retreat to the forest.
You can't be serious. In this rain, Lady...
Be just fine. We are in Leonis, after all. Let us do as the lions do.
Mont, guard Lady Marcherie.
Yes, Father.
Mont. Oh, that's...
Yes, but...
I've heard the Prince of Leonis is one of the finest swordsmen in the land. With a temp...
Lady Marcherie, I believe you are mistaking him for the other prince, Prince Stern.
Oh, now I remember. Twin princes. As similar as a Moogle and a Marlborough. I see that now. Well then, Crown Prince, give us a show.